Hi, this is Dr. Scott Hahn with Body and Balance Wellness Center. And today what I want to help you understand is where does sciatica or sciatic pain come from? In order to help you better understand sciatica, I need to go through some brief anatomy. Now the sciatic nerve is a nerve that is made up of multiple nerves coming out of the lumbar spine. Multiple of these nerves actually come together to form the sciatic nerve, which then travels down the back of your leg and separates out into smaller nerves, some ultimately ending up in your feet. Now typically sciatica involves pain, numbness, or weakness that travels down the back of your leg and potentially all the way down to your foot. The pain pattern normally follows the path of the involved nerve and most commonly on one side of your body. Now even though there is pain in the buttock, back of the leg, or even the foot, that doesn't necessarily mean that is where the problem is. So what can actually cause these annoying or debilitating symptoms? Now the first and most common one is actually coming from your spine. You have all these bones in your low back, and if any of them become misaligned through bad posture, accidents, injuries, or just plain overuse, even high levels of stress can lead to an increased tension in the muscles. What happens is if one of these bones actually shifts out of place, it can put direct pressure on the nerve or the nerve root itself. If bad enough, it can additionally cause an inflammatory reaction, which will cause even more pressure on the nerve root. Unfortunately, if that misalignment or improper movement pattern stays there long enough, it can lead to a herniated disc. This is where part of the nucleus, the middle part of the disc, gets squished out and can put pressure directly on the nerve itself. The next most common cause of sciatic symptoms is actually coming from a small muscle in your pelvis called the piriformis. Now the piriformis is a muscle that creates stability in the pelvis for the hips so you can stand upright. It runs horizontally across the pelvis. Now for some reason, the hip, or if there's hip or pelvic misalignment, it can cause the muscle to go into spasm. Now just like with the low back, if this muscle spasms, it can directly compress the nerve and create the sciatic symptoms. Now unfortunately in some people, this nerve directly pierces through the belly of the muscle. So any imbalance can create a lot of problems. Now I know everything I just talked about sounds really bad, but that doesn't mean you have to have surgery. We've helped a lot of people regain their health and life back through conservative care. Now, if you want to find out more about if we can help you, please give our office a call. We'll evaluate you to make sure you're in the right place. And if for any reason you're not, we'll let you know. Remember, create health by choice, not by chance.